After this module, you will be good enough to design the RCC foundation in real life, as well as you will be good enough to score 20 out of 20 marks in your ESC mains. Okay, 20 out of 20 marks in ESC mains, leave it to me. Just watch this module, you will be more than perfect. Before I start teaching you all this theory associated, what does this IAS codebook actually says, let us try to design the foundation in real life directly. Okay, after that we will see the concept behind it. So first of all, what you see when you visit to some structure, whenever you visit to some construction site or any building, what is the thing which you basically see? You will be seeing columns, right? On these columns you will be having beams. On these columns you will be having what? You will be having beams. So let us say these are my columns, I will be having my beams joining these columns, agreed or not? On this beams I have slab, I have slab. So whatever the load which is acting on the slab, first of all, it is being transferred to what? It is being transferred to my beams. Whatever the load which is acting on the slab is being transferred to my beams. And the beams, what are they doing? They are transferring these loads to columns. They are transferring these loads to columns. So if you are seeing the structure, you will be seeing the columns are taking this load to the soil, right? Yehi aapko dikhega na, yahan pe aapko ground level aa jayega. Here you will be having the ground level, and you will be seeing this column is actually taking the load to the soil, and the soil is taking the load. But this doesn't happen. This is what you can see above the ground level. Below ground level, we have a substructure. We are calling it as foundation. We are calling it as foundation or footing in general. Okay. Why we need this footing? Let us try to understand. When a certain load is acting, let us say there is no footing, just column I have extended to certain depth. Okay, just column I have taken to certain depth and I have left it like that in soil. What will happen? Let us try to understand. When a certain load is acting, let us say, just for example, 100 kilonewton load is acting. Okay, so this much load is acting on a very small area. Column dimension kitna rahega? It will be 300 mm into 450 mm. In general, we will be taking 300 mm into 450 mm, or in some cases 300 mm into 300 mm. Such a small area, right? 0.3 meters into 0.3 meters. So 0.09 meter square. So such a small area, this load is acting. If the load is acting on a small area, what will be the stress? What will be the stress acting here? The stress will be very high, because stress is nothing but the load divided by area. As area is very less, my stress will be very high, and the soil cannot take this much amount of stress. So kya ho jayega? Failure ho jayega. This will be moving further down, because the soil got sheared, it cannot take that much load, so it will be moving down, and my structure is going to tilt and collapse. I hope you are getting the concept, right? The other ways of failure also, we'll discuss it later on. But I hope you are getting the concept. If the load is acting on a small area, then the stress will be very high. Soil cannot take this much amount of stress, and failure will occur. Right? Soil, how much amount of stress it can take? You might have learned in your foundation engineering a term called a soil bearing capacity, a safe bearing capacity of your soil. Right? Safe bearing capacity you might be knowing from your foundation engineering. Yahan pe bhi wahi hota hai. So whenever you are designing, you will go to a geotechnical engineering first. This geotechnical engineering, after checking the soil, after doing certain tests, plate load test jo bhi karega karega, and then finally gives soil bearing capacity. He will say, bhaiya, you cannot go more than 20 kilonewton per meter square in this area. Then as per the soil bearing capacity, I will be designing the area of foundation. Now what is happening? Whenever I am designing a foundation, so what is happening? The same load, 100 kilonewton, is acting on a larger area now. I hope you are getting it right. The same 100 kilonewton load is acting on a larger area, but let us be very careful. You are adding certain concrete here, right? The foundation part wala concrete. So the weight increases slightly. Let us say now the load is 110 kilonewton. What happened? Now the load is 110 kilonewton. You can even consider the soil above it. But for the time being, let us ignore. How much you consider, it doesn't matter, because you have considerably increased the area now. So what will happen? The stress acting now, P by A, will be very less. My sigma will be very less, because area I have drastically increased. From this 0.3 into 0.3 meters, let us say I have increased the area to some 2 into 2 meters. 4 meter square, इतना बड़ा एरिया, सो ऑब्वियसली द प्रेशर वॉट एवर इज एक्टिंग विल बी वेरी लेस नाउ, अग्रीड और नॉट? सो माई स्ट्रेस हियर इन दिस कंडीशन इट बिकम्स वेरी लेस एंड ऑब्वियसली इट विल बिकम लेस देन माई सॉइल बेरिंग कैपेसिटी. नाउ माई स्ट्रक्चर इज सेफ. द स्लैब्स आर ट्रांसफरिंग द लोड्स टू द बीम्स, बीम्स आर ट्रांसफरिंग द लोड्स टू द कॉलम, loads is transferring the load to the columns are transferring the loads to the foundation, and foundation is dispersing this load to the soil easily without failure. Concept samajh gaye aap? Now when I am talking about design, what should you actually design? Whenever I am talking about design of foundation, what are the various things you have to decide? Very simple hai baba, very simple. All you have to do is you have to design the foundation dimensions. You have to design the foundation dimension. For example, let us say this is how your foundation looks. Okay, let me remove the column here. So this is how your foundation looks. So you have to first decide what is the area, that is your length and breadth. So first thing in designing a foundation is to decide the dimensions, length into breadth. Second thing is to decide the depth. This is also very important. If you are not providing enough depth, right? Not only area, if you are not providing enough depth, even then failure can occur. How? Let me explain you later on. So, two important steps, length, breadth and depth. So, what is the last and most important step? Bhaiya, what are we studying? We are studying RCC foundation, reinforced cement concrete. So, obviously you should tell how much reinforcement you have provided. So once you tell how much AST you have provided, your design is complete and you will be getting your 20 marks. There will be various different types of problems associated. In general, for 20 marks in mains, this type of simple questions will be given to you. In real life conditions, obviously there will be some biaxial moment also generated in the structure. Load to aayega, there will be biaxial moment also. For example, load is coming along the height, right? Let us say the load is along the y axis, so you will be getting biaxial moment mx and mz also. Then how you will design? Very simple, same concept repeats. Just remember, what will be the stress now? Stress will be p/a, plus because of the moment also certain stress will come. So how much will be that stress because of moment? m/z. Or if you don't understand the language of z, so you can use the same thing, right? m/i is equals to stress divided by y. So you can send y here. I want stress. So m/y/i. Like that also you can write it down. It is up to you. Or you know i/y is nothing but z, right? So you can write section modulus z. You can directly write as z. So here let us say this is mx/zx. Okay. Plus mz. If you are having biaxial moment, if you have single moment, this is enough. But if you have biaxial moment, which is the general case in structure, then m along the z axis divided by your section modulus along the z axis, it should be less than your soil bearing capacity. It should be less than your safe bearing capacity of your soil. Soil and structure will be safe. As per that, you will be designing your area, you will be getting your length and breadth, and then decide your depth, and then decide how much area of steel you are providing. Problem is complete. Okay, so now let us see step by step how to fix your length, breadth, depth and AHT. Concept to perfect hona, concept to samajh gaya aap, everything is clear. So the first step is to find out length and breadth, right? So how to do it? Very simple. You might be aware by now that the loading whatever is acting. See, if you know this depth exactly, if you know what is this depth exactly, in some questions it will be given. Okay, so if you know all this, you can find out the exact load whatever is acting here. Okay, the exact load which is coming from the column plus the weight of this foundation and the weight of soil here, you can consider like that. Or if nothing is given, if you don't know anything, just to start your problem on a trial and error basis, consider whatever this load is there. No, it is 0.1 times of the load which is coming there. Okay, so p plus 0.1 p, this is trial and error method. Exact nahi aayega, trial and error method. So I'm just considering whatever the load extra is there because of this foundation part as 10% of the load which is getting to that foundation. So I'm getting p plus 0.1 p. divided by my area, whatever I am providing, I don't know, I have to find this out, divided by area, it should be less than what? Soil bearing capacity. So what will be my area? My area, it should be nothing but greater than P plus 0.1 P divided by soil bearing capacity. You know the load, load aapko pata hai. You know soil bearing capacity, foundation engineer de dega, and in problem also it will be clearly mentioned. For example, on solving you are getting this as some 11 meter square. So your area, it should be greater than 11 meter square. So what you can do, you can take it as, you need not use calculator and overthink, aisa kuch zarurat nahi hai. You can just take the normal numbers, whichever is closest to it. So I will consider this is the area required so that my soil will not fail, because it is safe in soil bearing capacity. Itna to aapko provide karna hai. This is the minimum area which is required. So area, whatever you are providing, right? Obviously it should be more than area what is required, common sense ki baat hai, right? So area whichever you are providing, right, it should be greater than area required. Based on that you can design the dimensions. So if I am taking 4 into 3, that is length is 4 and width is 3, okay, and your width is 3, it is more than enough. You will be getting 12 meter square, and this 12 meter square is greater than area required to support that soil bearing capacity, and your structure will be safe. Okay, and your structure will be safe. So from here you can design your length and breadth. This is how you will be getting your length and breadth. The first step is complete. First step samajhne aa gaya aapko. The second important step, how to decide the depth of my footing. This is a very important step, beta. Not only length and breadth, you should also knowing the depth of it. Let me make it very, very clear. यहाँ पे एक प्रॉब्लम है. IS कोड बुक क्लियरली सेज योर डेप्थ शुड बी ग्रेटर देन 150 mm, नो मैटर व्हाट. 150 mm से कम आप कभी डिजाइन नहीं करोगे, बट इन मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस यू माइट हैव टू गो टू 300 400 500. दिस इज अ वेरी बेसिक डेप्थ व्हाट एवर वी प्रोवाइड फॉर फाउंडेशन. हाउ टू कम टू दिस कंक्लूजन, दिस हाउ मच डेप्थ यू रिक्वायर, दिस डिपेंड्स अपॉन यूअर शेयर, दिस डिपेंड्स अपॉन यूर शेयरिंग एक्शन. लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज हैपनिंग. So whenever the load is being transferred from column to foundation, so you know one simple logic, right? There is a certain stress which is acting on the soil, agreed? There is certain stress which is acting on the soil, the load divided by area. But Newton ne kaha tha, every action has equal and opposite reaction. Only then the things will be in equilibrium, right? So let us try to understand, there is certain force with which the foundation is trying to push the soil. With the same force, my soil is trying to resist it, agreed or not? So there is a certain upward force acting here. There is a certain upward stress acting here, agreed or not? Samajh mein aa gaya concept? So there is some upward stress like this, or upward force you can say for the time being, and there is a downward force like this, agreed? So yahan pe kya ho raha hai? There is upward forces and there is some downward forces, agreed or not? So obviously whenever there is an upward and downward force acting, there is a chance of shear failure. Let us try to understand, there is a downward force going like this and there is an upward force coming like this. So what will happen? This will get tore. That means it is getting sheared. Tearing, shearing, one and the same. Okay, tearing is nothing but shearing. So just imagine if both are acting down, will this paper get tore? Not right. If both are acting up, will this paper get tear? No. If I have one side acting down and other side acting up, only then there will be tearing action or shearing action. Concept samajhne aa gaya? So as there is some upward force acting and there is some downward force acting, this whatever I have, my foundation, it could go shear failure. It will go what? Shear failure. So using this concept, we can decide what should be your depth of footing. Let us try to understand. If the footing depth is less, then it will be sheared something like this. Agreed or no? Then it will be sheared something like this. If the depth is more, okay, even if the load is acting, will there be any shearing action? As the depth is more, the area which is resisting the shear will be very high. मैंने बोला था इफ अ सर्टेन फोर्स इज एक्टिंग लाइक दिस, दिस पेपर इज गेटिंग टोर्न. बट जस्ट इमेजिन आई हैव टेकन सम 20-30 पेपर्स टुगेदर. और जस्ट फोल्ड दिस पेपर. Now try to tear it with the same force. Will it get tore? No. What you have increased? You have increased the depth. Agreed or not? Whenever I am increasing the depth, it won't be easy for me to have the shear failure. But if the depth is very less, let us say this is the depth. Now the shearing failure will easily occur. If the depth was more, will the shearing failure occur? Can you tear it easily? No, right? Concept over here. If I am increasing the depth, then it won't be failed. So I just have to find out at what depth my shearing action is not taking place, and that will be the depth of your foundation. Simple hai? Samajhne aa gaya concept? How to design it? There are two types of shear. One way shear. Other aake, obviously two way shear. Two way shear is also called as punching shear. We will discuss this later on. But based on this one way shear, we decide the depth of footing. So let us try to understand. Two way shear is more like a check whether it is suitable or not. One way shear, it gives us the depth of footing. So here I have said the critical section. Remember the critical section, very important bit. It is d meters away, effective depth. Okay, total depth is d. Total depth of footing is capital D. Effective depth of footing, that is up to this reinforcement bars, the effective depth, I am calling it as small. So the what is the critical section? Critical section is d meters away from the face of your column. If this is my column, from the face of my column, critical section will be d meters away. This is given in code. Let us see from the top view. So I will be having my foundation. This is land, this is breadth, and this is my column. From d meters away from face of column, I have my critical section. This is my critical section. Let us say the face of column, right? A column ka dimension A hai, and this side it is B. Now what you can take is, you can take some particular section, any particular section. Let the width is 1 meter. So what is the section which is resisting this shear force at this particular section? If I am considering the width, I am taking a section whose width is 1 meter and the depth which is resisting is 1 meter. So what is the area which is resisting the shear force? Area resisting shear force at that section will be B into D. I have taken B as 1 unit, right? So 1 unit or 1 meter. So my area resisting is 1 into D. I hope it is very clear. So to get shear stress, that is nothing but my shear force divided by area which is resisting it. So what is my shear force? Shear force will be nothing but the load which is acting in this shaded part. Common sense ki baat hai. What is the load which is acting? I know there is some upward force acting. So Wu into this area. This whatever is there. Okay. So how to get it? Very simple. Total length L. So up to this part, up to the center part, that should be L by 2. Or how you can see this is, just give me a second. Just consider this part. How much is this part together? That will be nothing but L minus the column wala width, right? So that is L minus A. So if it is L minus A and L minus A this much, so what will be one part? One part will be L minus A divided by 2. Agreed or not? So this part width, you can clearly see that is L by A divided by 2. Agreed or not? So what is L by A by 2? That is the total part, but I want only this section. So what I am doing? L by A divided by 2 minus, I know it is d meters away. Simple, into my width. Width I have taken as 1 meter. Agreed or not? That strip width is 1 meter. So my shear force is nothing but the shear stress, the upward stress whatever is acting, into the area. This will give me the shear force acting on that section divided by area which is resisting, that is 1 into. This is shear stress. Finish. Aage aapka shear stress. This is your shear stress. And what you have to do with this shear stress? You have to check with the tau c value whatever is given. Your shear stress should be less than your tau c. Your critical stress se kam rehna chahiye, that's it. K into tau c to be precise. Okay. This K value is always greater than 1 if your depth is more than 300 mm. Kisne kaha? Maine nahi kaha, code book ne kaha hai. So where is our code book? Let me open the code book also, that will be convenient for us. Just give me a second. You can see this table here, just give me a second. You can see this table now. So if the depth is less than 300 mm, you can see the K value. K value for 275 is 1.05. If it is only 150 mm, then your K value is 1.3. like that it will be changing. But most of the cases you need not remember this table, because generally depth will be providing more than 300, therefore your K value is 1. So you can directly go for your shear stress, whatever you are getting should be less than 1 into tau c, or directly less than tau c. Now how to get tau c? Tau c to next table mein hi hai yaar, just thoda niche aa jao, aap thoda niche aa jao, you will be getting your design shear strength of concrete tau c. Okay, you will be getting tau c. If you see this table, you need two parameters. The first one is grade of concrete, which you will be knowing in question. Obviously, whoever is going for construction, he knows what is the grade of concrete, whether it is M20, M30 or M25, doesn't matter, it will be given in the question also. But you also need area of steel. If you see properly, you also need 100 AST divided by B. You need area of steel, and corresponding your concrete, you will be getting your tau c value. For example, if your area of steel is 0.25, okay, 0.25%, then for M25 concrete, your tau c value is 0.36. Like that, from this table, you will be getting it. If you don't know anything, if because I'm just starting, I don't know what is the area of steel I have to provide. So I am taking an assumption. This is based on an assumption. But my tau c value, I'm saying, I'm taking the tau c value corresponding to 0.2% of steel. So what I will be taking, for example, if I want M25 concrete for 0.2% of steel, what will be my tau c value? Here it is 0.29 for 15, it is 0.36 for 25. So for my 20, it will be, the difference gap is 7, so that is 3.5 more. So I will be getting 32.5 for my M25 concrete and 0.2% of steel. From here up, tau c utha loge, and you will be checking whatever the value is, this it is less than particular value. For example, let us say 0.36, whatever you want, right? So you will be just checking it. You know the WU value, you know what is the WU value, you know what is the length of column, sorry, length of foundation, because first step was designing the length and width. You know what is the column dimension. So only unknown in this equation is D. Only unknown in this equation is D. So if you are sending the D, you will be getting a certain equation, and you will be knowing what is the D you have to provide. For example, you got D as 400 mm. You got D as 400 mm. What will be your capital D? What will be your total depth of your foundation? What will be your total depth of your foundation? Very simple. That will be D plus D kahan pe rukega? Obviously, at the center of your reinforcement. If the reinforcement bar dia is 5, then I can write it as D plus 5/2. I will be reaching the bottom of that bar plus my clear cover or nominal cover. My clear cover. In foundation, if nothing is given, what is your clear cover? It is 50 mm. For example, if you are using 10 mm steel bars, then what will be your capital D? That will be 400. Plus 10/2, which is 5, plus 50. So 455 will be your requirement. You can provide kabhi aisa 455, 460 odd nahi dena hai, provide D is equals to 470. You can write D provided as 475, and as per the, you can decide your depth. Okay, depth will be minus 55, which will be 425. It doesn't matter. I hope you got it right. Some 420. I hope you got it right. Samajh mein aa gaya concept, how to decide your depth. So now you know all the three things. You know what is the length, what is the width, and what is the depth of your footing. You know all the three dimensions. There is one more check, which is called as two-way shear. Two-way shear. It is mostly like check. Two-way shear. वो हम बाद में देख लेंगे. First, let us see the fourth one, which is area of steel. How to know how much steel you are providing. Very simple है. Very simple concept है. See. There are in two ways you have to provide the steel, along the main reinforcement and along the distribution. Let us say this is your top view. This is your top view. Along the length, you will be providing your steel bars. Along the length, you will be providing steel bars. And along the shorter dimension, you have to provide another distributed steel bars. Another distributed steel bars. So how to calculate how much steel you have to provide? First, let us see along the length how much you have to provide. The main reinforcement, whatever you are providing, let us try to understand. Okay, the main reinforcement and ischioper, if you are seeing like this, you will see. That means the long bars along this and distributory is along your shorter side. I hope it is very clear, right? So how to get this? How to get this? Very simple. Now I will be using the bending moment equation. So first thing is, you know what is WU, right? Find out what is the bending moment acting. Find out what is the bending moment acting. So take a particular section and find out what is the bending moment acting. Very simple. So this, you know, that is L minus A by 2. Agreed or not? Abhi toh dekha tha last time. The total length is L, right? If you are taking the column dimension out, that will be how much on one side? L minus A by 2, L minus A by 2 on this side. Agreed or not? Very simple. So I know the length. Consider it as unit width. So calculate what is your bending moment. My bending moment will be nothing but upward stress, whatever is acting, into L minus A by 2 whole square divided by 2. It is similar to this, right? It is similar to this. I want moment at here. The WU is acting. So what it will be? WU into L into L by 2 into L by 2. So I am getting WU into L minus A by 2 whole square divided by 2. Simple, yaar. Everything is so simple here. There is nothing to worry. Very simple concepts. So from here you will be getting a very important term, your bending moment, how much is acting at that section. So I know a very simple formula, that is AST is equals to 0.5 FCKBD divided by FI into 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 BMU divided by FCKBD square. यहाँ पे मैंने यूनिट विड्थ लिया था, सो बी इज अगेन 1, यू नो द डी हाउ मच यू हैव टेकन, यू नो एफ वाई विच इज स्ट्रेस इन स्टील, जनरली विल बी यूजिंग 500 एफ वाई 500 दिस डेज, ओके, मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस इट इज एफ वाई 500, इफ नॉट एज पर क्वेश्चन 415 इज गिवन, यू कैन टेक 415, ओके, एफ सी के यू नो M20 और M25 वॉट एवर, जस्ट सब्सटीट्यूट. You know BMU, you have just calculated, right? WU into L minus A by 2 whole square divided by 2. So just substitute, you will be getting area of steel you have to provide. You will be getting area of steel you have to provide from this section. That is along the main part, along the length. You can similarly get along the width also. For example, this is B, right? So what will be this dimension? This dimension will be capital B. If total is capital B. B minus small b divided by 2. So if you are considering a section of unit to width, what will be your bending moment? Bending moment will be nothing but WU into B minus B by 2 whole square divided by 2. So you know the bending moment. Find out what is the steel you have to provide along this direction also. AST is equals to 0.5 FCKBD divided by FI into 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 BMU by FCKBD square. Substitute, directly get what is the steel you are providing along this shorter direction. Samajhne aa gaya? So this is how you have to decide. And one important concept. So you have to write once you get the AST, right? Check for AST minimum also. Check for AST minimum. IS code book says minimum of 0.12% you have to provide. 0.12% of area you have to provide minimum as your reinforcement. For example, if your AST is 500 mm², if you are doing this, you are getting your AST as 550 mm². So in this case, what will be your AST you are providing? It will not be 500, but AST minimum 550 mm². This much amount of steel you will be providing. Okay, you will be providing. Now let us decide what is the diameter of bar you are providing. Okay, let us say what is the diameter of bar and spacing you have to provide. See, what is the length? Let us take 2 meters. Let us take 2 meters. The length is 2 meters or 2000 mm. The diameter of bar, let us take 10 mm or 12 mm. 12 mm bar le lenge. So diameter of bar, let us take 12 mm. सो 12 mm मीन्स एरिया कितना रहेगा, एरिया एएसटी ऑफ 12 mm बार, इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग इट शुड बी सम 113 mm स्क्वायर, जस्ट कैलकुलेट वंस एंड चेक. सो एरिया ऑफ वन 12 mm बार इज 113. सो टोटल एरिया आई नीड वॉज 550 mm स्क्वायर. सो हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ बार्स आई रिक्वायर पर मीटर, पर मीटर आई रिक्वायर 550 डिवाइडेड बाई 113, विच इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 4 bars और 5 bars विद 5 bars. Because I will be getting 4 point something. So obviously you cannot provide 4 point something. So you can provide 5. You can provide 5 bars per meter. Or you can do, keep it like that only. N 4 point something, whatever you got. Just find out what is the spacing of it. Spacing kaise aa jayega? Spacing is nothing but very simple. 1000 mm divided by this value. This value, 4 point whatever you are getting. You will be getting your spacing, let us say 250 mm. Okay, so this is a spacing. You can write, provide 12 mm diameter bar at 250 c by c. End of story. Agar aap aisa likh doge, area of steel provided is 12 mm bars at 250 c by c, more than enough. No one is going to question you blindly. He will be giving you 20 out of 20. Samajh mein aa gaya concept? So this is how you have to design the foundation. Now let us see the concept as well as the check. Kuve shear wala check. And before that, in general, if the question is asked for 20 marks, this is how you do. But how the experts do, how the pro people do, how they actually design in real life. Hum kya karte, STAAD use karte. Okay? I don't calculate how much load actually it is being acting on my foundation. How to get everything? Whenever I am designing a structure, this is how the STAAD, a simple structure. So what I have done, I have designed it, and when I am analyzing it, just give me a second. Go to output file, done. If you want to learn how to do the STAAD design, complex designs, complex buildings in STAAD, just comment down. I will make a module. If there are a lot of people requesting, I will make a module how to design the entire building in one module using STAAD. तो यहाँ पे सिर्फ कॉन्क्रीट डिजाइन आ गया है, सॉरी, जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकंड. सो हाउ द बिल्डिंग रियली लुक्स लाइक, हाउ द बिल्डिंग इज रियली लुक्स लाइक. सो दिस इज हाउ द बिल्डिंग लुक्स लाइक. ओके, सामने से आपको कुछ इस तरह से दिखेगा. आरसीसी, यू कैन सी बीम्स, यू कैन सी कॉलम्स. ओके, सो यहाँ पे वट एवर द स्पेसिंग यू आर सीइंग राइट इन देयर, यू विल बी गेटिंग द वॉल्स, ब्रिक वॉल्स यू कैन ऐड. ओके, लाइक दैट यूर बिल्डिंग विल बी लुकिंग लाइक. दिस इज हाउ योर बिल्डिंग लुक्स लाइक व्हेन यू आर डिजाइनिंग इन योर स्टैंड. सो जस्ट गिव मी अ सेकंड. यहाँ पे मैंने रिएक्शन ऐड नहीं किया है, इंक्लूड नहीं किया है. सो वॉट आई एम गोइंग टू डू इज जस्ट बेयर विथ मी, दिस इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू योर कॉन्सेप्ट, बट यू शुड नो वॉट पीपल एक्चुअली डू टू गेट टू डिजाइन द फाउंडेशन. सो जस्ट लेट मी प्रिंट द रिएक्शन ऑल्सो, प्रिंट रिएक्शन. आई एम गिविंग अ कमांड दैट आई नीड अ रिएक्शन ऑल्सो. सो आई हैव सेव्ड इट, क्लोज. नाउ आई एम एनालाइजिंग द स्ट्रक्चर. This is a structure which I have recently designed. So view output file. Let us go to results directly. Just wait for it. Concrete design nahi tha pehle. As soon as I have given the command, I need reaction. Reactions bhi aa gaya. Now see the second column, force Y. Let me take a screenshot and paste it somewhere else so that, just give me a second. See this now, I have pasted it here. So this is how you will be getting, whenever you are designing the structure, you will be getting how much force it is going down. For example, at this column one, what it is going? The force which is acting in y direction, that means the force, the load, whatever is acting is this much for different load combination. Obviously, you will be taking the maximum kitna yahan pe? 424 I can see. So I will be designing the foundation for the load of 424.59 or 425 आप ले लो. एंड वॉट आर द मोमेंट्स एसोसिएटेड, देर इज बायएक्सियल मोमेंट बीइंग जनरेटेड, -1.55 -45.0. सो फॉर दिस आई विल बी डिजाइनिंग माई फाउंडेशन, फॉर दिस आई विल बी डिजाइनिंग माई फाउंडेशन. एंड ऑफ स्टोरी. ओके, सो यहाँ पे मुझे इनपुट्स आ गए, बेस्ड ऑन दिस इनपुट्स आई विल बी डिजाइनिंग माई फाउंडेशन. देर इज ऑल्सो स्टैट इन विच यू कैन डिजाइन द फाउंडेशन डायरेक्टली. देर इज वन सॉफ्टवेयर स्टैट का, स्टैट फाउंडेशन. But I found the results are not satisfactory using it. Okay, whenever I am using the IS codebook, results are not satisfactory. So after getting those values, I do in-hand calculations only. Even when I'm designing the structure in real life, whatever structures I have done based on my hand calculation only. I generally generate an Excel sheet in which when I give the inputs, right, automatically the dimensions are there. Like that, I have designed my foundation. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? This is how the pros do. For your examination level, whatever I have taught you is more than enough. Now quickly let us see the theory associated and end this module. So there is some bachchon ka topic, some small children's topic here, which is not that needed for you. Small children's topic, what is it? That what are the types of footings, what are the types of foundations we have. चाहिए क्या आप लोगों को? देर इज टू टाइप्स ऑफ फाउंडेशन, लाइक शैलो फाउंडेशन, डीप फाउंडेशन. बच्चा बच्चा भी जानता है. नो नीड टू वेस्ट टाइम ऑन इट. सो आइसोलेटेड फुटिंग, व्हाट इज द आइसोलेटेड फुटिंग? इफ फॉर ईच कॉलम इफ यू हैव सेपरेट फाउंडेशन, देन इट इज आइसोलेटेड फुटिंग. बट इन सम केसेस, जनरली एट द लैंड बाउंड्री, वी गो फॉर कंबाइंड फुटिंग. वी माइट नॉट बी प्रोवाइड दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ एरिया लाइक दिस बिकॉज ए लैंड बाउंड्री पे आ गया. I don't want my foundation to cut and go into someone else's property, right? So main kya kar raha hu? I am limiting it. For example, let us see. I will be limiting the area and I will be joining with the next column so that it will be balanced. The area whatever is required will be satisfied in this way. Okay, this is called as combined footing. So no need to worry much. And I have also provided some simple theory. एक बार देख लेना, मोर देन एना. ओके, रिलेटेड टू कंबाइंड फुटिंग, आइसोलेटेड फुटिंग, आई हैव गिवन अ सिंपल नोट्स, जस्ट रीड इट वंस, मोर देन एनफ, यू कैन इजीली लर्न. नेक्स्ट इज प्रेशर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ सॉइल. एज आई हैव टोल्ड अर्लियर, व्हाट विल बी द स्ट्रेस विच इज एक्टिंग ऑन द सॉइल? इट विल बी ड्यू टू द लोड पी बाय ए. एंड अगर मोमेंट आ गया तो यू हैव टू कंसिडर मोमेंट ऑल्सो. Plus or minus m by z, or you can write m into y by i. It is up to you. So if a p by a plus m by z, we don't have any problem. This is the compressive force. But p by a minus m by z, if it becomes negative, that means there is tension coming. How will be the diagram if it becomes negative? It will be something like this. This will be my positive compressive force, and negative wala part jo bhi hai, that is in tension, right? And concrete is not good in tension, and I don't want tension in my foundation at all. I hope you are getting it right. Therefore, make sure that your P by A minus M by Z value is greater than 0. Okay, worst case, it should be 0. Okay, so let us see where the load should act. Obviously, if the load is acting away from a certain distance, then we can get this condition P by A minus M by Z less than 0. Okay, what is that condition? In which area my load should be acting within my foundation so that my whatever this stress, no, it is greater than 0 all the time. So answer is very simple. What I am doing, I am just equating P by A minus M by Z is equals to 0. Simple calculation hai, M kya ho jayega? Load into that distance. If I am considering it is acting at eccentricity E away, then P, my moment will be nothing but P into E, right? So if I am just substituting for a rectangle, simple rectangle, whatever, I will be getting my E is equals to L by 6. If your eccentricity where the load is acting is at this distance away, then what will happen? Then you will be getting tension, or you can say one end will be lifting up. Okay, I hope it is very clear, right? Samajhne aa gaya concept? So always follow this middle third rule. Remember this, very important. You might have learned this in SOM and many other subjects also. Here also it's same. For non-zero upward pressure from soil, that is no lifting condition, the resultant load must pass through middle third of plan area. This is also called as middle third rule. This is not related to us, but basic information. Chotu chotu questions. In chotu chotu like examinations you can have it. That's why I have given. Okay, so now let us see very important caudal provisions. Aapke notes mein 5 star de dena. Very important for SSC JEE. What is the minimum thickness of your foundation slab, your footing? Minimum dimension 150 mm. So you can have anything greater than 150 mm, but never less than 150. Generally you will be providing more than 300 itself, because my K value will become 1 and my shear stress will be less than equals to K tau c. Directly I can write it as less than tau c. Okay, Very simple. So minimum nominal cover, what is the minimum nominal cover you have to provide when it comes to foundation? It is 50 mm. Okay, so base dimensions of footing of plain cement concrete should be such that following condition must be satisfied. This is not important for you, not at all important. So here it is giving how the stress actually like moves, okay, how the stress diagram is actually being distributed. Okay, so this whatever the tan alpha, you have to design the foundation such that this, if you are joining the column wala end and your footing wala end, your tan alpha should be greater than 0.9 under root 100 q naught by fck plus 1, where q naught is your upward pressure. Okay, where q naught is your upward pressure. So your tan alpha should be greater than what? 0.9 into under root 100 q by fck plus 1. Problems will not come, but the formula will directly come in SSEJ. You have to tick the right formula. Tan alpha is greater than 0.9 under root 100 q naught by fck plus 1 more than 5. Okay, and there is also, this is a very important thing, give it 5 star. Maximum bearing strength of concrete is 0.45 fck under root a2 by a1. Okay, if you are having a gusset plate like this, area is acting at a1 and it is being distributed to a2 like this, you can use this formula. If not, if in question it is given a1 and a2 are one and the same, then it will become 0.45 fck, as simple as that. So what does this give? This gives maximum bearing strength of concrete. In short, it is giving maximum load a concrete can take without failure. You know how to get your bearing strength? Load divided by area, right? So for, if once you get this, you can decide how much load a concrete can actually take. Okay, agar usse zyada hai, then it will exceed your strength and your concrete will fail in some or some condition. That's how you have to understand it. Okay, so maximum bearing strength of concrete is how much? 0.45 fck under root a1 by a2. Okay, a2 by a1, sorry, it's not a1 by a2, it is a2 divided by a1. Very important, sorry for my mistake. 0.45 fck under root a2 divided by a1 is your bearing strength of your concrete. So what is this a2 a1? Very simple, there is nothing much. So for example, if this is your base plate, generally in steel structures what we do is, आपका जो कॉलम आता है ना, स्टील का बना हुआ रहता है. सो व्हाट वी डू इज, वी कनेक्ट इट विद द बेस प्लेट, एंड बेस प्लेट हम सीधा लेके जाके फाउंडेशन में गाड़ते थे. ठीक है, फाउंडेशन में गाड़ते थे, मींस टॉप ऑफ फाउंडेशन ओनली वी विल बी पंचिंग इट इन समवेयर हियर, वी विल बी हैविंग बेस प्लेट एंड ऑन दैट वी विल बी हैविंग अ स्ट्रक्चर. सो दिस इज माई A1. नाउ लोड विल बी ऑब्वियसली ट्रांसफरिंग इन वॉट एवर रेशियो इट इज मेंशन, इफ नॉट जनरली 1:2. सो this wherever it is cutting, right, that will be your a. I hope it is very clear, right? Samajh mein aa gaya concept. For example, let us say if your base plate is inclined towards one side of your foundation, it is somewhere here. Okay, so this is a1, this is a1, you have no problem. Now what is A2? What is A2? Very simple, Baba. Just draw this. Just keep drawing it. Wherever it is cutting, right? Wherever it is cutting, just draw the line. This will be your A2. This will be your A2. Wherever it is cutting, stop it. So that line, whatever you got along this slope, this line, just find the area along it, you will be getting your A2. Okay. So what will be your bearing strength? 0.45 fck under root A2 by A1. See this question, he is asking what is your permissible bearing strength of concrete, FBR. How to get it? 0.45 fck. He has given M30 concrete. So 30 into under root A2 by A1. So what will be my A1? My A1 base plate area is 0.5 into 0.5. And what will be my A2? Let us try to understand. It is 0.15 meters away. So yahan pe bhi kitna aayega? 0.15 meters away. So 0.5 plus 0.15 plus 0.15, which will be 0.8. So my area is 0.8 along the length and 0.8 along the breadth. So this will be my bearing strength. I will be getting 2.16. Let us end this module by seeing the design steps once again. Design of isolated footing. See, very simple. Whenever I have a isolated footing, I am designing for this load whatever it is coming on footing. But there is weight of footing, and also there is certain backfill on this footing, right? When I have drawn this footing, there is a soil resting on it. Uska bhi weight add karega, agreed or not? So what I am doing is, I am imagining the load acting at the base of footing is P plus 10% of the weight. So 0.1 P divided by A. Okay. So this will be the stress. And this stress should be less than safe bearing capacity of soil. If it is more than safe bearing capacity, fail. Safe bearing capacity means the capacity which could be easily taken by the soil, safely taken by the soil. If your limit is exceeding it, fail ho jayega. Common sense ki baat hai. So it should not exceed and it should be less than safe bearing capacity of soil. I hope it is very clear. So my what will be my area required? A cup ka hai. So let me erase this. So what will be my area required? Very simple, Baba. P plus 0.1 P by area. It should be less than soil bearing capacity. Just rearrange. So area which is required is greater than P plus 0.1 P divided by soil bearing capacity. End of story. Okay. So this is area which is required, and you know that it should be greater than this value. So you can take anything greater than it. For example, area required, you got some 2.9. Okay. Or let us say 3 meters. 3 meters square is area required. So you provide area provide 2 into 2 meters. So how much you are providing? You are providing 4 meters square. Obviously, if you are providing something more, then it will be safer, right? Common sense ki baat hai, because what is happening? P plus 0.1 P. He is saying 3 meter square ka to provide karna hai so that it will be less than safe bearing capacity. If you are providing 4, then it will be more safe than you. Agreed or not? So area provided, I am taking 4. See, you can take close to 3 also, but I will not suggest it. Aisa mat kar dena, 3 you will provide, sir, I will provide 1.7 exactly. 3 aa jayega. No, aisa mat karo. Give some gap, because this is a trial and error, right? So I am taking only 0.1 P as weight of my foundation and the weight of soil which is resisting on it. Beta, based on my experience, I am saying it, see, it will be much more than 0.1. So if you are taking this very close to area required, agar 3 aa gaya, if you are taking length and breadth such that if you are multiplying, you are getting 3.2 now. प्रॉब्लम फेस करोगे कहां पे प्रॉब्लम फेस करोगे चेक्स में वेन एवर यू आर डूइंग द चेक वन वे शियर चेक टू वे शियर चेक वहां पे पड़ जाएगा वहां पे शॉर्ट पड़ जाएगा यू विल बी लूजिंग यू विल बी गेटिंग योर स्ट्रक्चर फेलिंग ओके सो टेक सम गैप एटलीस्ट इफ यू आर गेटिंग थ्री प्रोवाइड फोर ओके आई होप इट इज वेरी क्लियर राइट थोड़ा गैप दे दो सो दैट वेन एवर दिस वॉट एवर इज रिक्वायर्ड 0.1 पी के बदले में इफ इट इज लिटिल बिट मोर ऑल्सो ना then also it will satisfy and your design will be safe and you will get correct answer in the first go itself. But make sure that you are not giving more also. Aisa nahi hai ki you got 3 meter square and you are providing 3 meter into 3 meter. Aisa mat karo. Okay? It should be close but at a reasonable distance. I hope it is very clear. Samajh mein aa gaya. So next, let us try to calculate the upward pressure of soil. Okay? What is upward pressure of soil? That is nothing but whatever is coming down, that is resisting now. So as simple as that, my upward pressure will be P plus 0.1 P divided by area which you have provided. Itna pressure act karta. Common sense ki baat hai. Now calculate net upward pressure. This is very important step, beta. We have to calculate what? Net upward pressure. Why net upward pressure? Let us try to understand. Even when column and foundation is not there, soil to yehi pe tha. Right? Agreed or not? So we are not interested in it. This whatever soil is there at this some d meters depth of foundation depth, it is taking the change of stress because of the load whatever is acting. Agreed or not? Because of the load whatever is acting. So aapko kya karna hai? You have to find out what is the net addition of weight. So what you have to do? You can remove this 0.1 Pa. You can remove this 0.1 Pa. So, aapka net kya ho jayega? W net is equals to W naught, the upward stress, minus 0.1 P divided by area provided. Is tarah se aap jo add kare the, wo remove kar rahe hain. I hope it is very clear, right? If the conditions are pre-given to you. Now, you know the stress. Instead of taking 0.1 P, if you already know this depth, exact depth, and this as 0.4, whatever it is, no, you remove the weight of your foundation as well as weight of the soil. How to remove? Very simple. If it is 2 meter, what will be the weight of soil? There is a foundation, okay, column hai, haan baju mein pura kya hai, soil hai, right? So length into breadth you will be getting area, and height is 2 meters. So 2 into L into B, this is volume into density kar loge, okay, volume into density of soil, 18 kilonewton per meter cube, whatever is there, dal lo, substitute kar lo, you will be getting weight of your soil as well as weight of this foundation. Weight of foundation bhi aap nikal do. So how much it will be? You can calculate 0.4, if the depth is 0.4, 0.4 into length into breadth into density of concrete, which will be 2500 kg per meter. Kar lo, aapko aapka weight aa jayega. So you can remove it. So your W net will be W naught minus 0.1 P divided by area provided. So your W net, whatever you are getting, right? So for this we will be designing. For this we will be designing. How will be designing? Very important beta. So the upward pressure, whatever we have, upward pressure, whatever you have. See, in the beginning I have taught you roughly, I have given you a rough idea. This is the exact one. Yaad rakhlo, the upward pressure, I am taking it as 1.5 times W net. 1.5 times W net. This is very important. Okay, yaad rakhoge, your upward pressure is 1.5 times W net. This is, I am designing for the ultimate weight. So 1.5 times the net weight which is there acting, no, I am taking it as W naught, and for this I am designing. The remaining steps are very simple. Now what you have to do, you know already length into breadth, right? Area aapne pehchana tha, so you know LB. What is the next step? To calculate the depth. How to get depth? From one way shear. So critical section is, this is a very important bit for your SSC. Critical section for one way shear is at a distance d from the face of column. Is at what distance? It is at d distance from the face of column. Is at d distance from the face of column, not capital D, small d. Okay, effective depth distance from the face of column. So as I have told before, take a strip of 1 meter width. Okay, so kahan pe daloge? Critical section is d meters apart. So you have to calculate shear force acting. Shear force kaise aa jayega? Shear stress into area you can do, right? So you know what is the stress which is acting, right? W naught, you know, into area of the strip. Into area of the strip you have to find out. Area kya ho jayega? Width I have taken 1 into this length. What is this length? Are yaar, common sense ki baat hai, total length is L. Remove the column. So what will be this part? Plus this part, that will be L minus A. Half of part will be L minus A by 2. End of story, right? So W naught into L minus A by 2. But there is one more thing. L minus A by 2 is this part. This part is L minus A by 2. I want only this part at D meters apart. So W naught into L minus A by 2 minus D is the right area, right? So if you multiply, you will be getting your shear force, or what is the load which is acting, divided by the area which is resisting it. What is the area which is resisting it? Let us try to understand. Just give me a second. So area, yahan pe dekho, yahan pe cut ho raha hai na, yahan pe shear ho raha hai. So what is the area which is resisting? Breadth is 1, and what is it resisting? The depth is resisting, right? So depth kitna hai? This d. Okay, so 1 into d. So you just divide it. It should be less than equals to your tau c value. Okay, it should be less than equals to k into tau c basically. But in general, the depth you will be providing will be greater than 300. So k value will become 1. And you have to take tau c. See, you don't know how much is the steel requirement, because tau c table 19 se aega. For M20, M25, everything will be having value. For a particular steel amount, you will be given different value. So what you have to do, we are taking at a lesser, we are assuming the steel amount is less. I am just taking it as 0.2% of my area. And I am taking that value corresponding to tau c. Okay. So what I will be getting, WU L minus A by 2 minus T divided by D less than equals to tau c. Tau c value I know, WU value I know, L value I know, A value I know, only value I don't know is D. From this equation, I will be getting D is greater than equals to a particular value. Okay, let us say 350 mm. Then you can provide D is equals to 400 mm. So, aapka capital D kya ho jayega? Capital D kya ho jayega? 400 प्लस ऑफ द डायमीटर ऑफ वायर प्लस क्लियर कवर प्लस क्लियर कवर सिंपल आई होप यू गॉट इट. नाउ लेट अस सी फॉर टू वे शेयर और पंचिंग शेयर. दिस आई हैव नॉट थॉट यू राइट. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड पंचिंग शेयर मीन्स वॉट विल हैपन इफ यू पंच इन टू अ कार्डबोर्ड और समथिंग. वहां पे इट विल ब्रेक राइट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई हैव अ कार्डबोर्ड एंड आई एम पंचिंग हियर. सो दिस पार्ट विल बी ब्रोकन. अग्रीड और नॉट दिस पार्ट विल बी ब्रोकन. सो आई होप इट इज वेरी क्लियर राइट. सिमिलरली वेन एवर देर इज अ कॉलम देर विल बी ब्रेकिंग अप लाइक दिस. देर विल बी ब्रेकिंग अप लाइक दिस. देर विल बी अ क्रिटिकल सेक्शन विच इज एक्टिंग एट डी बाई टू फ्रॉम द फेस ऑफ कॉल. ओके इन वन वे शेयर इट वॉज एट डी. इन टू वे शेयर इट इज एट डी बाई टू. सो डी बाई टू दैट साइड डी बाई टू दिस साइड. सो टोटल कितना हो जाएगा इफ दिस इज ए दैट इज साइज ऑफ लेंथ ऑफ कॉलम यू कैन से. सो दिस विल बिकम ए प्लस टू. सिमिलरली यहाँ पे बी प्लस टू इफ दैट डायमेंशन ऑफ कॉलम इज बी बी प्लस टू. ओके सो यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है इट इज गेटिंग पंचर्ड एंड गेटिंग फेल्ड. सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ दिस दिस इज हाउ योर स्ट्रक्चर इज. दिस इज माई कॉलम एंड ये जो पार्ट बन रहा है दैट इज माई फुटिंग. सो वेन द लोड इज एक्टिंग इट इज पंचिंग लाइक दिस. कॉलम नीचे चले जा रहा है फाउंडेशन ऊपर आ जा रहा है. ओके इट इज पंचिंग लाइक दिस. आई होप यू गॉट इट राइट. सो अ होल फॉर्म हो जा रहा है एंड इट इज कमिंग डाउन. कॉलम इज कमिंग डाउन. हाउ टू चेक फॉर टू वे शेयर. वेरी सिंपल. वेरी सिंपल है. सेम यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट वॉट इज द शेयर फोर्स विच इज एक्टिंग हियर अलॉन्ग दिस पोर्शन वॉट एवर आई हैव शेडेड राइट. अलॉन्ग दिस रेक्टेंगल वॉट इज द शेयर फोर्स एक्टिंग एट दट सेक्शन डिवाइडेड बाई एरिया विच इज रेसिस्टिंग इट. एरिया विच इज रेसिस्टिंग इट. एंड ऑफ स्टोरी. एंड ऑफ स्टोरी. वॉट इज एरिया विच इज रेसिस्टिंग इट. फर्स्ट बोल दो इन द प्रीवियस केस वेन आई हैड दिस वन मीटर एंड द डेप्थ कितना था डी मीटर. सो एरिया रेसिस्टिंग वॉज वन इंटू डी राइट. बिकॉज वन मीटर यहाँ पे इंटू डेप्थ मीटर नीचे. नाउ सिमिलरली वॉट इज द मीटर्स आई हैव. आई हैव ए प्लस डी मीटर्स एंड हियर बी प्लस डी मीटर्स अलॉन्ग द पेरीमीटर ऑफ दिस राइट. अलॉन्ग द पेरीमीटर ऑफ दिस. सो टोटल पेरीमीटर इज हाउ मच. ए प्लस डी प्लस बी प्लस डी. इट इज अ रेक्टेंगल राइट. इंटू टू. इंटू टू दैट इज द टोटल पेरीमीटर. सो आई गॉट द लेंथ ऑफ इट इंटू डी. इंटू डी. सो दैट इज द रेसिस्टिंग एरिया. कॉमन सेंस की बात है. वेरी सिंपल राइट. सो वॉट इज द शेयर फोर्स विच इज एक्टिंग एट दैट सेक्शन. वॉट इज शेयर फोर्स विच इज एक्टिंग एट सेक्शन. सो आई एम कंसिडरिंग दिस लोड वॉट एवर इज एक्टिंग इज पी राइट. सो फॉर डिजाइन पर्पज आई एम नॉट टेकिंग पी. टू बी ऑन अ सेफ साइड आई एम चेकिंग इट फॉर 1.5 पी और आई एम राइटिंग इट एज अल्टीमेट पी. अल्टीमेट लोड. ओके पी यू कितना है 1.5 पी. आई एम चेकिंग फॉर दिस. सो दिस स्मॉल थिंग्स यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. सो 1.5 पी और पी यू माइनस अपवर्ड वॉट एवर यू गॉट. सो इन दिस सेक्शन वॉट विल बी यूर अपवर्ड. दिस इज द डाउनवर्ड पी यू एंड वॉट इज द अपवर्ड इन दिस सेक्शन. इन दिस सेक्शन अपवर्ड कितना काम कर रहा है. सो दैट विल बी नथिंग बट द डाउनवर्ड फोर्स डब्ल्यू यू इन टू एरिया ऑफ दिस रेक्टेंगल वॉट एवर रेक्टेंगल इज बींग फॉर्म. सो ए प्लस टी लेंथ इन टू ब्रेथ विच इज बी प्लस टी. एज सिंपल एज दैट. दैट इज द अपवर्ड फोर्स. दिस इज द डाउनवर्ड फोर्स. दिस इज कॉजिंग यूर नेट शेयर. अग्रीड और नॉट. सो पी यू माइनस डब्ल्यू यू ए प्लस टी इंटू पी प्लस टी डिवाइडेड बाई टू इंटू ए प्लस डी प्लस बी प्लस टी इंटू डी. सो दिस इज यूर शेयर स्ट्रेस. ओके वेन एवर यू आर कंसिडरिंग टू वे फेल्यूर और पंचिंग फेल्यूर दिस इज योर शेयर स्ट्रेस एंड द कोड बुक सेज इट शुड बी लेस दैन के बी 0.25 अंडर रूट एफ सी के. के बी इंटू 0.25 अंडर रूट एफ सी के. सी दिस 0.25 एफ सी के न्यूटन पर एम एम स्क्वायर. ओके सो एफ सी के यू नो वॉट इज फॉर कॉन्क्रीट. इफ इट इज M20 कॉन्क्रीट यू जस्ट हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट 20 राइट. 0.25 कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. के बी. सो कमिंग टू दिस के बी वी हैव वैल्यू एज मिनिमम ऑफ 1 or 0.5 plus b by d. So when you have a column, let us say this is a, this is b. So 0.5 plus b by a or 1, whatever is minimum, we will be taking it as my k. Samajhne aa gaya? I hope you are very clear about your kb value. Just substitute and check. So here you already know the depth. So when you are substituting, and this value, for example, let us say this is some 0.3. Okay. So whatever you are getting here, it should be less than 0.3. Let us say 0.25. Then it is safe. But for example, if the value you are getting here is 0.32, iska matlab kya hai? In two way, it is getting failed. The depth you have provided, just considering one way shear, is not enough. improve the depth, increase the depth further so that it will not fail in two-way shear. But 99.99% of the cases which I have designed, if it is satisfying in one-way shear, mostly it will satisfy in two-way shear also. Most of the cases I have seen. Okay, so no need to worry, but a check aapko karna padega. Who knows, there could be a special cases also, so do it. Now next is design for bending or calculation of AHD. Okay, calculation of steel to be provided. So you have to remember the critical sections, a very important bit for state BSE examinations for concrete. If this is where the column is acting, critical section for bending will be at the face of column itself. For shear force, one way it was d meters away, right? It was d meters away. But if for bending, it will be at the face of column itself. Okay, yaad rakhlo, for concrete slab is supported monolithically casted column wall, then critical section is the face of column or wall. But remaining 2-3 cases are there, these cases can be asked. When concrete slab is supporting masonry wall, okay, there is a concrete slab which is supporting a masonry wall, ek wall bana diya hai. Critical section will be at mid of centering of wall and face of wall. So kahan pe rahega? First you draw center line of a wall, ye jo center line, let us say this is center line of wall, and face of wall ke beech mein rahega. This is face of wall, let us say this is face of wall. Okay, so one is center line, two is face of wall. So where will be a critical section? Critical section will be mid span of your face of wall and center line of wall. That means at, if wall is of thickness t, center line kahan pe? T by 2 ke paas aayega. So where will be your critical section? That will be at t by 4. That will be at t by 4. One of the bit you have to remember. And next, generally in steel structure this will come. When footing slab is supported by steel column. So when you have a footing slab supported by a steel column with gusset plate. Obviously whenever we have steel column, yahan pe gusset plate aa jayega. This is my gusset plate. The critical section is at mid span, mid of the face of column and edge of gusset plate. Okay, so mid of the face of column, yaad rakhlo, mid of the face of column and edge of gusset plate. So this is edge of gusset plate, and just give me a second, let me take red. Yeah, and this is face of your column. So beech mein aayega aapka critical section. Okay, I hope you remember right. So this is your gusset plate's edge and this is face of your column. So mid span will be considered as your critical section. I hope it is very clear, right? And where you will be getting maximum bending moment, use your common sense. Use your common sense. So if you have something like this, this is length, this is breadth. Length is greater than breadth and you have a column like this. So along the longer side you will get maximum bending moment or the shorter side? Common sense ki baat hai, along the longer side. Along this longer side you will be getting maximum bending moment. Why? Because if you are considering a strip at the face of column, so W upward pressure into distance, WU into distance L, that is the load into L by 2. This will be the bending moment acting at this section, agreed or not? So obviously you can see L is more here, the small L is more, therefore your bending moment is more. So critical section AU hoga. For example, if you are considering along the shorter side, take this area, L is very less here. So what is your bending moment? Let us say LWU L square. As L is less, bending moment is less. So bending moment is more along the longer overhaul, and that will be your main steel you are providing. And along the shorter side, that will be your distributory steel you are providing. I hope it is very clear, right? Samajh mein aa gaya aapko? So you just find out what is bending moment along this side. Use the formula AHD is equal to 0.5 FCK BD by FI into 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 BMU by FCK BD square. You will be getting your AHD. And similarly, find it for shorter overhang along this side also. You have to find out and make sure you get your AHD. Remember, whatever AHD you got along the length or breadth, it should be greater than AHD minimum. If not, provide AHD minimum. Okay. If for example, AHD along the longer side is 600, along the shorter side is 400, and AHD minimum, which is 0.12% of area. Okay, so let us say it is 500. Then along the longitude, along the length, you will be providing 600 mm square steel, and along the shorter side, you will be providing not 400, minimum provide karna hai 500 mm. Done. And here comes a very important part, very important formula, very important concept, which has been asked in SSC multiple times. See, in this foundation and column diagram, you can see the load is acting more obviously at the column, right? The load is acting where the column is touching the foundation. So what is happening here, the stress will be obviously little bit more compared to overhangs, agreed or not? जहाँ पे लोड ऐड कर रहा है वहां पे रीइंफोर्समेंट की ज्यादा जरूरत है. देयरफॉर आई एम क्लासिफाइंग दिस इनटू टू ग्रुप्स. ओके, वन इज आउटर बैंड एंड वन इज सेंट्रल बैंड. फॉर एग्जांपल लेट अस से दिस इज बी, दिस इज एल. सो शॉर्टर डायमेंशन फ्रॉम द सेंटर साइड यू टेक इट, दिस विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज यूर सेंट्रल बैंड एंड द रिमेनिंग पार्ट यू विल बी कंसिडरिंग वॉट एवर दिस हियर यू हैव दैट इज कंसिडर्ड एज आउटर बैंड. दिस इज आउटर बैंड. And shorter dimension will be considered as central band. This is central band. I hope it is very clear, right? So number of steel bars, you know number of steel bars from the AST, right? You know number of steel bars you require from AST. For example, whatever you are doing here, right? ये जो bending moment of find कर रहे हो, we have considered as unit width, right? B is equals to 1 meter, and in that 1 meter, you are getting this much amount of steel you have to provide, right? So in 1 meter, you know what is the amount of steel you have to provide. Agreed or not? So you decide the dimension of a bar. Area of one bar, let us say of 10 mm, whatever it is, you will be getting, right? AST of, like for example, 12 mm provide kar rahe ho. So what will be the AST? 130 mm square. So the number of bars required will be the total AST divided by area of each bar. So you will be getting number of bars you are providing. End of story. एंड ऑफ स्टोरी. इतने बार्स आपको प्रोवाइड करना. ओके, सो यू विल बी गेटिंग एन टी, यू विल बी गेटिंग एन टी एंड टोटल नंबर ऑफ बार्स यू विल बी गेटिंग अलॉन्ग द शॉर्टर साइड यू विल बी गेटिंग. सो एन सी द नंबर ऑफ बार्स यू हैव टू प्रोवाइडेड इन सेंट्रल बैंड. कितने प्रोवाइड करना है आपको सेंट्रल बैंड में? वी हैव टू फॉलो दिस फॉर्मूला. मोर बॉल्स शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड इन द सेंटर बैंड, राइट? सो हाउ मेनी यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग? एन टी इंटू 2/1 + L5. I hope it is very clear. How many you are providing? NT into 2/1 by L + B. Sorry, 1 + L/B. Yaad rahoge? So NC is equals to NT into 2/1 + L/B. Never forget, these many bars you have to provide. In some small exams, direct this formula will be asked. NC is equals to NT into 2/1 + L/B. You will be getting your 1 mark. In something, question can also come and you will be getting your 1 mark. सो ऑल द टारगेट है ये स्टूडेंट्स प्रैक्टिस दिस क्वेश्चन. यहाँ पे जो मैंने क्वेश्चन दिया है, प्रैक्टिस दिस क्वेश्चन. यहाँ पे इफेक्टिव कवर कितना है? 50 नहीं दिया है, 75 दिया है. रिमेंबर दैट. ओके, रिमेंबर दैट. सो फाइंड आउट यूर डी, डी प्लस डायमीटर ऑफ बार वॉट एवर यू आर डिसाइडिंग प्लस 75 mm. दिस विल गिव यू कैपिटल डी, द टोटल डेप्थ ऑफ यूर कॉलम ऑफ यूर फुटिंग. ओके, सो जस्ट ट्राई इट. Try this problem now itself. You should be a gems in this topic. Okay. So after finding out, it will be more than enough. Next is combined footing. Combined footing is similar to that of isolated footing. Kuch zyada farak nahi hai. So one way shear, two way shear, same hai isolated footing. But what is happening in combined footing is bending moment is dominant near the columns. Okay. Therefore, what we are providing? We are providing more reinforcement near the columns, very similar to that. But what is the area in which you are providing more reinforcement? Let us try to understand. We are providing, for example, if this is A1, I am providing in this length of A1 plus 1.5D, depth of your effective depth of your foundation. Okay. If this is A2, in this bandwidth of A2 plus 1.5D, I will be providing most of the steel, and remaining I will be providing nominal steel bars. I hope you got it. Okay, so this is what it is given here. Please see, remaining everything is same. So this concludes the chapter, and next chapter is a pre-stressing, which I will be making one module. Both will be using for crash course and regular school. Okay. So, and one more thing I have missed here. Just give me a second. One more important thing I have missed. Where is it? This is quite important. Wait. Just give me a second. Where is it? Shayad main nahi likha yahan pe. Just give me a second. I should have written it somewhere. I don't leave my notes like that. Just let me check a very important point. See this point, it could come in examination. So whenever you are deciding load plus moment, designing load plus moment. So what actually happens is whenever you have a column, right? We design as if it is at exactly center of your footing. Okay. The center of gravity is actually matching. CG point is matching. Column or foundation ka beech mein rahega, center mein rahega. If you are seeing from top, if it is a rectangle, you will see only at center. But actually when the moment is acting, no? When the moment is acting, what we actually do is, we don't keep it at center anymore because there is a moment also. There is load and moment also. Okay. So, you know, moment, if moment is equal to P into E. Okay. So, what I am doing is, let us say this is center line of my column. Center line of my column. So, instead of matching the center line of column and foundation, I am moving my foundation by a distance. I am moving my foundation by a distance of okay, the center of gravity of foundation, I am moving by a distance of E. For example, if this is my foundation and here it has its center of gravity, I will be placing such that the distance between the center of gravity of my foundation and this column is at E mm apart. I hope you got it right. This could be asked as objective. Many people don't know this. Textbooks mein rehta hai. If you are reading the standard textbook, you will get it. Okay, so you have to place the center of gravity of the foundation EMM apart when actually moment is acting. So upar se kaise dikhega? So it won't be symmetrical anymore. It will be something like this. Your column will be here. The overhangs will be different. For larger overhang, you have to decide your bending moment. Common sense ki baat hai. And shear force also accordingly you can decide. I hope you got it. And remaining everything will be same. So no need, because at ESC level also they will be giving mostly load. Moment ka aap ignore. Moment ka zyada nahi deta hai. Even if asked, you can easily solve. Not at all a problem. You need not go for this approach also. Just remember for objective purpose and whatever I have taught you earlier. No? Just remember that. Okay. More than enough, you will be scoring out and out. Have a nice day. See you in next module.